Tony Robbins puts it, success leaves clues. In other words, successful people leave some pointers to the practices or behaviors that led them to achieve their success. And we can learn those habitual practices through research or by observation. We can study the journey they have traveled. I'm Catherine Gahu from SBO Research, where we provide business and social research services. In this video, I will talk about practices that we can learn from successful people that we can use for our growth in 2021. Whether we are pursuing growth in career, in relationships, business, finances, say financial independence, it doesn't matter. These are lessons that we can learn. We may be looking to grow in education, maybe to extend our education or to grow in sports or the arts, say even music or entertaining. No matter what you are looking for, we can learn some winning practices from those who have done it before. We want to learn from successful people because we do not want to reinvent the wheel, so to say. I will focus on the positive habitual practices because, as we all know, successful people also have some, so to say, bad or negative habits. So in this video, we only want to focus on what is good and positive for us so that we can learn, test, and apply. Another thing to be aware of is that good practices or behaviors or habits that will help you achieve something great are difficult to adopt and to form. They are not easy or quick solutions. They take effort, they take time, and they call for change. They call for you to act different, be different, and basically take the road less traveled. This calls for flexibility and an open mind. Now let's go direct to the winning practices of successful people to use in 2021. Be sure to stay until the end so that you can get the full benefit and find several ideas that fit well with you and which you will use to jumpstart your journey to achieving what you want in 2021. First, successful people practice long-term orientation. Many successful people achieve their recognition over a long period of time. Indeed, there are no overnight successes. As such, the reality is that it takes time to learn the right practices, to test them, and to implement them consistently until they become habitual and eventually produce outstanding results. Successful people plan over the long-term horizon and then commit to consistently do what is necessary to build the required skills, networks, and resources to win. Warren Buffett is famous for his insistence in having a long-term perspective, and his success with long-term investment is legendary. To quote Bill Gates, most people overestimate what can be done in 1 year, and they underestimate what can be done in 10 years. So long-term orientation is a key practice of successful people. Second, they start with what they have. Successful people start their journey from where they are and with what they have. Once they clarify what they want to pursue, they move with speed. And using what they have, they give no excuses. They take action and keep learning along the way. And they keep improving their strategies as they go along. They do not wait for everything to come together. The other day, while attending the Global Virtual Summit by Tony Robbins and Dean Graziosi, I got the opportunity to hear the famous success story of Eat Cosmetics from the founder herself, Jamie Kern Lima. She told us the story of her entrepreneurial journey, starting at her small city apartment with limited resources. She explained how she started after quitting her job as a news anchor and used her savings to make the beauty products, and the tough challenges she faced in the early years working with her husband and trying to get access to distribution outlets in America. She told us how it took her 2 years after getting so many no's before she finally got a yes to to the opportunity she was seeking, which was to present her product on QVC TV, where you get 10 minutes to present and basically sell to over 100 million American viewers. She went on to use this opportunity and this channel to build a massive billion-dollar business, which was eventually bought by the French cosmetic giant L'Oreal, where she continued to work as CEO. This story got me very excited because it reminded me of the Kenyan story of Paul Kenodia. You know, the story of Paul Kenodia of Kenya resonates very well with this story of IT Cosmetics. This is a story of how Kenodia started from a backyard with 3,000 Kenyan shillings, or basically $30. And he built nice and lovely from zero to a massive business, a big brand indeed, which was also eventually bought by L'Oreal, the French cosmetic giant, for serious cash, just like IT Cosmetics in the US. Amazing. These stories capture the third and fourth practices of successful people as well. Actually, even the first, because you can tell this is a long-term thinking, you can tell that it did not happen overnight. Third is that they practice persistence. These two entrepreneurs, Jamie Kan Lima of the US and Paul Kenodia of Kenya, demonstrate great persistence and determination. They stayed the course over time. Despite the challenges they faced, when obstacles came, they did not quit. They found ways to overcome. Fourth, they practice excellence. Successful people commit to working to develop something excellent or distinct or to become outstanding at what they do. Excellence is a habit, not a one-off action. Excellence comes from good practices that are implemented consistently, habitually, and repeatedly until they become daily routines. Successful people spend their time and energy finding ways to improve their knowledge, to improve their skills, their networks, and the like, so that they build unique abilities that enable them to stand out from the crowd. They get the power of distinction because of this commitment, and they become recognized as excellent at what they do or in their chosen fields. In the business world, excellence is associated with competitive advantage and high earning power. In life, in relationships, in everything, if you build excellence, you definitely get some advantages. If you take up just two or three of these practices and you follow them consistently, you will definitely see great results by the end of 2021 and exponential growth in the following years. As we said earlier, it's a long-term process. Before I close, I have a question for you. Which one of these practices will you commit to take up in 2021? Remember to subscribe and keep watching. We all need to elevate our mindsets at this time. Thank you and best wishes for the new year. Happy holidays.